name's Ron Stone. This is a bass lesson in Pride and Joy by Stevie Ray Vaughan. The song is tuned down a half a step, as pretty much all of Stevie Ray Vaughan's songs are, so you want to tune your E string to D sharp if you want to play along with the record. So it's just a blues. It's a 1-4-5 blues, and so it's just E, A, and B. And there's really not a lot of fancy stuff. He hits a couple of high notes on the record during the solo, but for the most part, it's not really anything fancy. If you watch a live version of it, you get a look at his fingers, you might see him playing around a little bit, but you could hold the structure of this song on the main bass riff the whole time and it would be just fine. That's normally what I do. I don't really fool around much on it. The band I play in right now is two guitars and a keyboard, so there's a lot going on anyway. And for the most part, there's a big criticism of bass players that they overplay. So one of the things I like about Tommy Shannon, the Stevie Ray's bass player, is that he doesn't overplay. He's a very in-the-pocket bass player. Sort of like the drummer. Chris is not a fancy drummer, but he's real tight, and he gets the feel he's supposed to. So I guess that's the magic of blues when it's done right, in my opinion. So the basic riff, you're starting it on the E on the 7th fret, and you're working your way back, while ideally you're hitting the open E string at the same time, so you're getting the shuffle feel. Da-doom, 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 da-doom. So, you can, depending on what you like in your ear, sometimes I like to hit the A, sometimes I like to hit the B, but for the most part I'm hitting the E and then the D and the C sharp alternately with the open E string. Okay, so and then I'm finishing off either hitting the A or the B, depending on what I'm hearing in the band. So, to my ear, I'm working with the studio version. I don't really hear him doing a lot of fancy transitions. Like, I don't hear him climbing up to the A chord so much. One option you could do, which may not be what he's doing, is you to get to the A chord, F sharp, G, and G sharp, but I don't really hear him doing that, so I just hear him pretty much going from the E and then doing the same thing on the A string. So let's get from the E to the A. Okay, so he doesn't hang on the A as long, and when he does get back from the A, which is the octave here on the 7th fret, he climbs back up chromatically to the E again. So he goes once through the A, and then... Okay, so it's just a chromatic from C sharp back up to E after that. And then back into the E chord. So the structure is, it's it's E, A, E, B. So after he goes back from the A, climbs up to the B. Okay, same way he climbed from the A to the E, he climbs from the E to the B. E, G sharp, A sharp, up to. And then he spells out the main notes of the A chord, of the B chord. Okay, it's pretty much a major scale. So, going from the E to the B, so it's, so you're working your way from that 5 B chord alright, back to the 1. So I'll go through that slow. It's basically like a B major scale almost, if you're skipping a couple of notes. So thank you. the top, okay? So the notes on that are B, and then E flat, F sharp, G sharp, A, which is your octave of A, and then you climb from C sharp to E, and then it's hard to do this and stop. I'm just always doing it in sequence. Oh yeah, and then the same thing with the E. You're going chromatically from E, starting at G sharp, chromatic. Okay, so you got E, G sharp, A sharp, B, and then C sharp up to A. And that's it, and it goes right back and it restarts. At the very beginning of the song, you saw me go in with him, and it's, I think it's kind of optional, but at the very beginning, when he does that beginning part, I just do A, G, D, and then start the E thing, those first three notes after he does that guitar intro. And the only other thing I think I hear, and it's, you know, it's kind of hard sometimes because the guitar mixes with the bass, is sometimes I might hear him going up to a couple of higher E notes during the solo part while he's backing him up on the solo. But again, that's not necessary at all. I mean, nobody's going to really, you know, toss up a fit if you're not hitting a couple of high notes, especially on the bass. So there's a philosophy in bass that says if the guitar player is playing low, that's a good time for the bass player to move up. So if your soloist starts soloing in the E key down by the first and second fret, maybe you can, when you're playing the E chord. But for the most part, that structure is what I play. So I'll play through it in its entirety without the record, so you can hear just the bass notes, and then you already have the full recording of the song, and you have me playing it at the beginning of this video with the record. So here we go. One other thought I had is that instead of moving up to the B during the turnaround, you can slide back down to the B. So on that B chord, you know, something along those lines, you know, just for a different flavor. But that's pretty much it. That's all the parts of it, and that's the feel of it. The big thing is to get that shuffle, ka-chung, ka-chung, ka-chung feel. So, and that's what, excuse me, hitting the open string helps you a lot with. I mean, you should be able to create that feel without the drums. And if you can do that, then you're doing your job on the bass. So good luck and have fun, and long live the music of Stevie Ray Vaughan. Thanks.